वेलकम टू ई लेक्चर सीरीज बीटेक फॉर सेन सब्जेक्ट डाटा कम्युनिकेशन एंड कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क्स। माई सर प्रकाश मीना, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग, इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज अजमेर। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद अवर टॉपिक नेटवर्क हार्डवेयर। वी विल नॉट डिस्कस ऑल अबाउट द नेटवर्क हार्डवेयर, सिंपली वी विल समराइज सम मेन टॉपिक्स। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ there are two types of transmission technologies that are in widespread use. So first is broadcast links and second point to point links. Point to point links connect individual pairs of machinery and to go from the source to the destination on a network made of point to point links. Short messages called packets in certain context may have to first visit one or more intermediate machines, and often multiple routes of different lengths are possible. So finding good one is important in point-to-point networks. And point-to-point transmission with exactly one sender and exactly one receiver is sometimes called unicasting. Then in contrast, on a broadcast network, the communication channel is shared by all the machines on the network, and packets sent by any machines are received by all the others. An address filled with each packet specifies the intended recipients, and upon receiving a packet, a machine checks the address field. If the packet is intended for the receiving machines, that machine processes the packets. If the packet is intended for some other machine, it is just ignored. And then next, the wireless network is a common example of broadcast link with communication shared over a coverage region that depends on the wireless channel and the transmitting machine. Also, broadcast system usually allow the possibility of addressing a packet to all destination by using a special code in the address field. When a packet with this code is transmitted, it is received and processed by every machine on the network. This mode of operation is called broadcasting. And some broadcast systems also support transmission to a subset of the machines, which is known as multicasting. So an alternative criteria for classifying network is by scale. Distance is important as a classification metric because different technologies are used at different scales. So here is the figure that so this shows the classification. So we classify multiple processor system by their rough physical size. At the top are the personal area network. They are meant for one person, and beyond this come longer range networks. This can be divided into local, metropolitan, wide area network, and each with increasing scale or size. And finally, the connection of two or more network is called an internetwork. And the worldwide internet is certainly the best known example of internetwork. So this is the classification of interconnected processors. Now we will go to individual topics already given in a diagram. So first is personal area network. Personal area network let devices communicate over the range of a person, and a common example is a wireless network that connects a computer with its peripherals. Almost every computer has an attached monitor, keyboard, mouse and printer. Without using wireless, this connection must be done with cables. And some companies got together to design a short range wire network called Bluetooth to connect these components without wires. And the idea is that if your device have Bluetooth, then you need no cables. You just put them down, turn them on, and they work together. And the system unit is normally the master, and talking to the mouse, keyboard, etc. as slaves. So the master tells the slave what address to use and when they can broadcast, how long they can transmit, what frequencies they can use, and so on. So Bluetooth can be used in other settings also. It is often used to connect a headset to a mobile phone without cord, and it can allow you digital music player also to connect to your car and other appliances. And a completely different kind of pen is formed when an embedded medical device such as a pacemaker, insulin pump or hearing aid talks to user operated remote control. Then pen can also be built with other technologies that communicate over short ranges such as RFID on smart cards and library books. Then next topic is local area network. The next LAN is a privately owned network that operates within or nearby a single building like a home, office or factory. LAN are widely used to connect personal computers and consumer electronics to let them share resources and exchanges information. And when LANs are used by companies, they are called enterprise networks. Wireless LANs are very popular in current time, so especially in home, older office building, cafeteria and other places where it is too much trouble to install cables. And in these systems, every computer has a radio modem and an antenna that is used to communicate with other computers. In most cases, each computer talks to a device in the ceiling. So this device called an AP access point, wireless router or base station replays packets between the wireless computers and also between them and the internet. And being the AP is like being the popular kid, like a school, and because everyone wants to talk to you. So however, it also computers are close enough, they can communicate directly with one another in a peer-to-peer configuration. And there is a standard for wireless LAN called IEEE 802.11, popularly known as Wi-Fi. And so wired LANs use a, we will not discuss about Wi-Fi ranges, so here we go to wired LANs. So wired LANs use a range of different transmission technologies. Most of them use copper wires, but some use optical fiber. LANs are restricted in size, and which means that the worst case transmission time is bounded and known in advance, and knowing these bounds help with the task of designing network protocols also. And the topology of many wired LANs is built from point-to-point links. IEEE 802.3, popularly called Ethernet, is the most common type of wired LAN, and a simple topology of a switched Ethernet also there. Each computer speaks the Ethernet protocol and connects to a box called a switch with a point-to-point link. And a switch has multiple ports, each of which can connect to one computer. The job of the switch is to relay packets between computers that are attached to it, and using the address in each packet to determine which computer to send it to. And to build large LANs, switches can be plugged into each other using their ports. And it is also possible to divide one large physical LAN into two smaller logical LAN. You might wonder why this would be useful. So sometimes the layout of the network equipment does not match the organization structure, so that's why we can use that. And there is an example. The engineering and finance department of a company might have computers on the same physical LAN because they are in the same wing of the building, but it is might to be easier to manage the system if engineering and finance logically each had its own network, and we can say virtual LAN or VLAN. In this design, each port is tagged with a color, say green for engineering and red for finance, and switch then forwards packet so that computers attached to the green ports are separated from the computers attached to the red ports, and broadcast packets sent on a red port, for example, will not be received on a green port, and just as through they are two different LANs. And there are other wired LANs topologies too. Switched Ethernet is a modern version of the original Ethernet design that broadcasts all the packets over a single linear cable, and at most one machine could successfully transmit at a time, and a distributed arbitration mechanism was used to resolve conflict. It is used a simple algorithm computers could transmit whenever the cable was ideal. If two or more packets collided, each computer just waited a random time and tried later. So we will call that version classic Ethernet. and both wireless and wired broadcast network can be divided into static and dynamic designs depending on how the channel is allocated. A typical static allocation would be to divide time into discrete interval and use a round robin algorithm, allowing each machine to broadcast only when its time slot comes up, and static allocation wastes channel capacity when a machine has nothing to say during its allocated slots. So most systems attempt to allocate the channel dynamically. And in dynamic allocation method, for a common channel are either centralized or decentralized. In the centralized channel allocation method, there is a single entity. For example, the base station is cellular network which determines who goes next, and it might do this by accepting multiple packets and prioritizing them according to some internal algorithm. In the decentralized channel allocation method, there is no central entity. Each machine must decide for itself whether to transmit. And many devices are already capable of being networked. This includes computers, entertainment devices such as TVs, DVDs, phones, and other consumers, electronics such as cameras, appliances like clock, radios, and infrastructure like utility meters and thermostats, and many more. Then next is metropolitan area network, covers a city. The best known examples of MANs are the cable television network available in many cities. This system grew from earlier community antenna system used in area with poor over the air television reception, and in those early systems a large antenna was placed on top of the nearby hills and a signal was then piped to the subscriber's house. So cable television is not the only MAN through. And recent development in high-speed wireless internet access have resulted in another MAN, which has been standardized as IEEE 802.16, is popularly known as WiMAX. And then next is wide area network. Wide area networks spans a large geographical area of any country or continent, and we will begin with wireless using the example of a company with a branch offices in different cities. So we will use different offices. So we will traditionally call them a machine as host, and the rest of the network that connects to these hosts is then called the communication subnet, or simply subnet. And the job of the subnet is to carry messages from host to host, just like the telephone system carries words from speaker to listener. In most WAN, the subnet consists of two distinct components: transmission lines and switching elements. So transmission lines moves the bits between machines, and they can be made of copper wire, optical fiber, and even radio links. And most companies do not have transmission lines lying about, so instead they lease the lines from a telecommunication company. And switching elements, or just switches, are the specialized computers that connect two or more transmission lines. When data arrives on an incoming line, the switching element must choose on outgoing line on which to forward them. And these switching computers have been called by various names in the past, also the name router is mostly used. And the short comments about the term subnet is an order here. Originally its only major meaning was the collection of routers and communication lines that moved packet from the source host to the destination host. And the WAN we have described, it looks similar to a large wired LAN, but there are some important differences that go beyond long wires. And usually in a WAN, the host and subnets are owned and operated by different peoples. And more in WAN, second most difference is that the router will usually connect different kinds of networking technologies. The network inside the offices may be switched Ethernet, and while the long distance transmission lines may be Sonet links, and some devices need to join them. The readers will notice that this means that many WANs will infect the internetworks and composite networks that are made up of more than one network. And final differences in what is connected to the network. So this could be the individual computers, as was the case for connecting to LAN, and it could be the entire LAN. And this is how larger networks are built from smaller ones. And we are now in a position to look at two or other variants of WAN. First, rather this lays dedicated transmission lines, like a company might connect its offices to the internet. This allows connection to be made between the offices as virtual links that use the underlying capacity of the internet. And this arrangement is called VPN, virtual private network. Compared to the dedicated arrangement, a VPN has the usual advantage of virtualization, which is that it provides flexible reuse of resources. And a VPN also has the usual disadvantage of the virtualization, which is a lack of control over the underlying resources with a dedicated line, and the capacity is clear. And with a VPN, your mileage may vary with your internet service. And the second variation is that the subnet may be run by a different company. So subnet operator is known as network service provider, and the offices are its customers, and the subnet operator will connect to other customers too, as long as they can pay and it can provide service. And since it would be a disappointing network service if the customers could only send packet to each other, and subnet operator will also connect to other networks that are part of the internet, and such a subnet operator is called an ISP, internet service provider, and the subnet is an ISP network, and its customer who connects to the ISP receives internet service. And in most WANs, the network contains many transmission lines, each connecting a pair of routers. And if two routers that do not share a transmission line with wish to communicate, they must do this indirectly via other routers. And there are many more things. There may be many paths in the network that connects the two routers, and how the networks make the decision is to which path is used is called the routing algorithm. And many such algorithms, routing algorithms exist, and how each router makes the decision as to where to send a packet next is called the forwarding algorithm. So there is more about WAN, but we will not cover here. So we will cover one point also here. So other kinds of WAN make heavy use of wireless technology. In satellite system, each computer on the ground has an antenna through which it can send data and receive data from to a satellite in orbit. All computers can hear the output from the satellite. In some cases, they can also hear the upward transmission of their fellow computers to the satellites as well. So satellite networks are inherently broadcast and are most useful when the broadcast property is important. And also an example of WAN is cellular telephone network. It's a WAN example. And wireless technology, using wireless technology that use WAN for connection from one cellular system to another cellular system. And last point is inter-networks. So many networks exist in the world, and often with different hardware and software. People connected to one network often wants to communicate with people attached to a different one, and the fulfillment of this desire requires that different and frequently incompatible network be connected. A collection of interconnected networks is called an inter-network or internet. And these terms will be used in a generic sense, in contrast to the worldwide internet, and which will always capitalize. And internet uses ISP networks to connect enterprise networks and home networks and many other networks. Subnet networks, inter-networks are often confused, so the term subnet makes that most sense in the context of a wide area network, where it refers to the collection of routers and communication lines owned by the network operator. And as an analogy, telephone system consists of telephone switches, offices connected to one another by high speed lines, and to houses and businesses by low speed lines. So these lines and equipments owned and managed by the telephone company and form the subnet of the telephone system. So telephone themselves are not part of the subnets. And a network is formed by the combination of a subnet and its host. And however, the word network is often used in a loose sense as well, and the subnet might be described as a network, and an internetwork might also be described as a network. So that's all about network hardware. You can go and search for more about network hardware on internet. So session ends here. Thank you.